Thanks for joining us on the CBN News Channel. I'm Ephraim Graham. Supporters of California's gay marriage ban are asking an appeals court judge to stay a federal court order allowing same-sex marriage to begin next week in California. Last week, Judge Vaughn Walker overturned Proposition 8, the constitutional amendment defining marriage as one man and one woman. On Thursday, he ruled gay weddings can go forward even while the case is being appealed. Heather Sells has more from the newsroom.
Judge Walker's latest ruling allows gay couples in California to marry beginning next Wednesday. But he did allow Prop 8 supporters to appeal. Still, he questioned whether they have the standing to appeal. His actions have outraged traditional marriage proponents.
This is just a continuation of his judicial tyranny to destroy the will of the people and to impose the will of the minority upon the majority.
On CBN's News Watch, traditional marriage supporter Maggie Gallagher argued that the judge should have suspended gay weddings until the appeals process is over.
When you're a lower court judge and you make a totally unprecedented decision that you know will be appealed, you normally stay that opinion and let the higher courts work out the law in an orderly fashion. So Judge Walker's failure to do so just underscores this is just one more of the chances that he had to act like a neutral referee, and instead he has acted more like a partisan.
On Capitol Hill, conservative lawmakers made the case for a resolution blasting Judge Walker and affirming the rights of voters to define marriage.
If this nation doesn't rise up, then we've capitulated to the judges, and it's the tyranny of the courts.
Of course, for gay rights supporters, the judge's decision is good news, and waiting till next Wednesday to marry is considered a minor inconvenience.
It would have been nice, but the 18th will be fine too, as long as someone doesn't come along and kill that ruling too.
The 9th U.S. Circuit Court of Appeals will eventually rule on Judge Walker's ruling that Prop 8 is unconstitutional. But in the meantime, it must decide whether to allow or not to allow gay weddings to go forward. Heather Sells, CBN News.
Heather, thank you. The man at the center of more than a dozen knife attacks in 3 different states is behind bars. Police arrested him at an airport while he was trying to board a flight to Tel Aviv. He is now refusing extradition to Michigan, where most of the attacks occurred.
During the last 4 months, Ilyas Abulazalem may have stabbed at least 18 people, killing 5. But that's before police arrested him at Atlanta's Hartsfield Airport just minutes before he would have boarded a flight to his homeland of Israel. Authorities believe his motive may have been racial, as 15 of the 18 victims were black.
He selected the victims in Leesburg based upon the color of their skin.
He lured his victims in Virginia, Ohio, and Michigan all the same way.
He drives up, he either asks for directions or he says his car is not working right, and he lures the suspect in, and then the stabbings occur.
He was just walking around the truck first, looking in the truck like he was looking for something. And then he came back to the front of the hood with me, and he was on my left side, and that's when he got the stabbing. He got to stab me, and I played like I was dead.
I asked myself, and I asked God why.
I've never hurt so much in my whole life. I've never come so close to death.
15 of the stabbings were around Flint, Michigan, terrorizing the town.
I'm scared for my kids. I'm ready to move. I'm not gonna lie. I'm ready to go.
When police showed this victim the suspect's photo Wednesday, he had no doubt authorities were right on track.
When I seen him, I knew who he was. Off back the first time, I didn't even know ifs, ands, or buts about it. I knew who he was.
But customers at Kingwater Market near Flint, where the suspect worked, have a rough time believing he's the killer or that race was his motive.
Well, out here, honey, we didn't have no problem with him. That's why we don't understand. It's like it's not understandable because he was out here with all of us.
He was a good guy. I mean, all of my employees, we never thought nothing about this guy. He was a friendly guy. He was a nice guy. I mean, it just threw us off.
But the manager is ready to see the worst punishment for his former employee if the man is guilty.
If it's him, he should be hanged.
It was shocking to even know that he was right here up under our nose.
And just as folks at Kingwater Market are shocked, so is the suspect's former father-in-law.
Pretty much so. My whole family's shocked. Yeah. Which is, something that you don't have happen to you every single day.
Abulazalem is from the Arab section of an Israeli town called Ramla. People who know him there say they don't believe he committed the crimes either. This week, an Ohio judge released Rivka Berry from state custody. Last year, Berry fled her Muslim parents, claiming they threatened her for converting to Christianity. Her parents denied the accusation, and a legal battle over custody ensued. Wendy Griffith looks back at the case.
On her 18th birthday, Christian convert Rivka Berry was released from state custody by an Ohio judge, ending a long legal battle to force her to return to her Muslim parents.
She's celebrating the end of a long journey.
A journey that began last year when Berry ran away from her home in Columbus and took refuge with Christians in Florida she had met on Facebook. She feared her parents would harm her for leaving the Muslim faith. Berry knew stories of other victims of so-called honor killings.
This is not just some threat. This is reality. This is truth.
Her parents denied the threats and began the legal battle to bring her home.
I never threatened my daughter. I told my daughter, look, Rivka, you are born Muslim. It is your duty and responsibility to learn your religion first, and you learn whatever you want and you decide on your own.
Police in Florida and Ohio found no evidence she was in danger, but she remained in state custody as a minor. Berry's plight struck a responsive chord in Christians around the nation and the world. Many attended this pro-Rivka rally in Columbus last winter. Former Muslim Nabil Qureshi understood the danger she faced.
It wasn't even a few months before I had received my first death threat, and it wasn't an anonymous one either. It was on my car. So I knew someone didn't want me alive, knew where I lived, and I was worried.
During this time, Berry also faced another threat to her life, cancer. She underwent treatment for uterine cancer.
She did go to a prayer conference, and then she took chemotherapy. She had surgery.
But today, Rivka celebrates the report that she is cancer-free. There remains one more battle, immigration. Berry is an undocumented immigrant from Sri Lanka. She's asking authorities to allow her to remain in the U.S. while she consults with doctors on how to keep her cancer from returning. Wendy Griffith, CBN News.
More than a billion Muslims around the world are celebrating Ramadan, Islam's holiest month. During Ramadan, Muslims pray and fast from dawn till dusk. In Israel, police beefed up security around the old city of Jerusalem. Tens of thousands of Muslims came to the city Friday to pray at the Al-Aqsa Mosque. Israeli Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu gave his annual greeting to the Muslim world. During the speech, he urged the Palestinians to agree to direct peace talks. On our Newswatch program, CBN Middle East Bureau Chief Chris Mitchell talked to Wendy Griffith about the prospects for peace and war in the Middle East.
This Ramadan story is very interesting because I think genuine peace is going to come when Muslims, Jews can celebrate the same way that Muslims celebrate Ramadan in Jerusalem. Hmm. Tens of thousands of Muslims come into the city of Jerusalem, but Jews cannot go to, say, the city of Ramallah, which is about a 10-minute drive away. I believe war is on the horizon. When it's going to come is a question that everybody's been asking in the Middle East. We saw about a week and a half ago an incident there on the Lebanese border when a Lebanese officer shot an Israeli officer.
Unprovoked,
exactly. And so that's something like that can actually provoke a war like it did 4 years ago. The main question is what Israel would do with Iran. Will they attack Iran's nuclear sites? Because they cannot tolerate a nuclear Iran.
You can follow the events in the Holy Land at CBN's Inside Israel webpage. Simply go to our website, cbnnews.com, and follow the links. Now to the flooding that has become the worst natural disaster in Pakistan's history. Millions of lives are at risk after weeks of monsoon rains. More than 1,500 people have been killed. 16% of the country is estimated to be underwater. John Waghi shows us the latest relief efforts.
A staggering 14 million people have been affected by the floods. That's more than the combined impact of the 2004 Indian Ocean tsunami, the 2005 Kashmir earthquake, and this year's Haiti quake. The official death toll in Pakistan has remained relatively low, but it could go much higher because entire villages have disappeared in the deluge.
6,000 villages wiped out the face of the earth. Now, from 5,000 to 50,000 a village, we have no way of counting.
It's estimated that 7 million people need emergency assistance. These people were asked if they've received help. The U.S. has pledged $71 million in aid, and military helicopters are helping with food drops. But the UN is calling for nearly $500 million.
Unless aid activities continue to be rapidly scaled up to reach those who remain displaced and without immediate access to food and clean drinking water, additional loss of human lives and further suffering will occur.
With weeks left in the monsoon season, people escape from the rising waters any way they can. Pakistan's government has been criticized for its slow response in aiding the victims. The speed of the rising waters caught the country off guard.
I think a lot of us haven't understood the scale of this disaster. It is horrendous. It is going to put us back so many years that we're not even starting on the infrastructure.
Pakistan's president toured the hard-hit Sindh region, trying to reassure the victims that they will survive the tragedy. John Waghi, CBN News.
New rainfall is triggering more landslides in China's northwest Gansu province. The heavy floodwaters are making rescue efforts difficult. 14 people have been killed. 20 people are reported missing. State media is reporting numerous cases of dysentery, but no epidemic yet. This is the most recent flooding. It comes on the heels of earlier mudslides that killed more than 1,100 people. Coming up, about one-third of its population is Christian, but Korea is seeing more suicides than anywhere else. The story next.
Open the eyes of my heart, Lord. Open the eyes of my heart.
These are the most powerful songs of our time.
Now is the time to worship.
And now, for the first time, the biggest praise and worship songs are together.
How great is our God.
Presenting Songs for Worship 50. 50 songs in one specially priced collection.
Holy is the Lord.
You'll hear 50 beautiful songs of hope.
I'm coming back to the heart of worship. And it's
50 powerful songs of faith.
Amazing love,
get Songs for Worship 50 on 3 CDs for only
$24.99. Here I am for worship. Here I am.
But wait. Order in the next 10 minutes with your credit card, and we'll take $15 off. That's right. You get 50 praise and worship songs for just
$9.99.
Then preview other great praise and worship collections. Satisfaction guaranteed.
Blessed be the name of the Lord.
So call now and get Songs for Worship 50. 50 beautiful songs on 3 CDs for just
$9.99.
Call 1-800-435-3414 to order Songs for Worship 50 on 3 CDs for $9.99 plus shipping and handling when you use your credit card. Call now or order online at timelife.com/songsforworship50.
South Korea is a predominantly Christian nation. About one-third of its population professes to be Christian. It is also the second-largest missionary-sending country in the world. Yet it also has the highest suicide rate of any country in the industrialized world. It's a situation that's prompting the church to take action. Here's CBN Asia correspondent Lucille Toulousan.
Choi Jin-sil was one of South Korea's most famous actresses. Her popularity could be compared to the way Julia Roberts is beloved by American audiences. However, in 2008, this beautiful woman who had the love of her country and a bright future hanged herself. Her suicide prompted as many as 700 more people to take their lives in the following months, including her own brother.
Sadly, committing suicide has almost become a trend among deeply troubled people here in Korea.
The suicide rate in South Korea is so high that it's now known as the suicide capital of the world. According to the Korean National Police, the number of suicides rose from 12,270 in 2008 to 14,579 in 2009, an almost 20% increase. Sociologists say a highly competitive atmosphere, uncertainty over the future, recession, and crumbling traditional social networks are to blame for these awful numbers.
I think Korea has so many stressful things. It is very hard for me to overcome those competitions and fight for everything with everyone.
Maureen Muratalia, a grade school teacher, says she was shocked to hear her young students talk about committing suicide because of the stress they face. Grade schoolers in South Korea attend extracurricular classes until 8 in the evening, while secondary students have additional classes that go as late as 2 o'clock in the morning.
I have a 12-year-old student, and one afternoon she told me that, "Teacher, I want to kill myself. I want to die." And then I asked her, "Why?" And she told me that my parents push me to study. I don't have time to rest, to play with my friends.
What's even more troubling about this deadly trend is that South Korea is a largely Christian nation, boasting 10 of the largest Christian churches in the world. The Korean Council of Religious Leaders is trying to address the situation by holding public education programs to combat suicide. Pastor Peter Kwon counsels people who suffer from depression.
If they learn the word of the Bible, if they meet Christ and have a relationship with God, that those things can truly change. Because with Christ in their lives, they can know that they're not alone. They can know that any obstacle that is in this world can be overcome through Christ, even though if it is a difficult one.
Churches are also speaking out from their pulpits, preaching sermons on the preciousness of life and that only God can take a life. Lucille Talusan, CBN News, Seoul, South Korea.
Suicide is the leading cause of death among South Koreans in their 20s and 30s and the fourth leading cause of death overall. Up next, how the government is joining the fight against school bullies.
Get ready to sing some praise.
Jesus, be evident.
Get ready to put your hands together. Time Life presents Shouting Down the Aisles, today's best traditional gospel.
You are let go and let God have his way.
30 foot stomping, hand clapping classics.
Long as I got King Jesus, long as I got King Jesus, long as I got him, don't need nobody else.
Get Shouting Down the Aisles on 2 CDs for just $24.99. But wait, order in the next 10 minutes with your credit card and we'll cut the price to just $14.99.
I gotta clean up what I messed up.
That's right, you'll clean up with 2 CDs, 30 songs for just $14.99. Then preview other great gospel CDs. Satisfaction guaranteed.
I'm a soldier.
Special collection is not sold in stores. So call now and start shouting down the aisles with 2 CDs for just
$14.99.
Call 1-800-366-4691 to order Shouting Down the Aisles on 2 CDs for $14.99 plus shipping and handling when you call in the next 10 minutes with your credit card. Or order online at timelife.com/shout.
Welcome back to the CBN News Channel. Here is the top story we're following for you today. Supporters of California's gay marriage ban are asking an appeals court to stay a federal court order allowing same-sex weddings to begin next week. Last week, Judge Vaughn Walker overturned Proposition 8. Thursday, he ruled gay weddings can go forward even while the case is being appealed. The U.S. government is fed up with school bullying. This week, the Department of Education hosted its first ever bullying summit. They're calling on both government agencies and private groups to help craft a national strategy to reduce bullying. The practice is growing at a disturbing rate. 32% of students reported being bullied at school in 2007. Bullying victims often suffer from low self-esteem, health problems, and suicidal thoughts. The governor of Massachusetts recently signed a bill cracking down on school bullies. The measure passed after two students committed suicide because of intense harassment from classmates. Charlene Israel has more on the deadly consequences of bullying.
Javaro Cherry is so concerned about his son's safety that he meets the 10-year-old at his bus stop every day after school.
Why do you feel that you have to pick your son up from the bus stop every day?
I know that as long as someone's up here, no one's gonna bother him.
His son Jalen is small for his age and has been the victim of relentless bullying by kids at his public school.
Some of them, they just come in your face and slap you.
His parents say their son is particularly afraid of one bully, and for good reason.
My son says that he was trying to beat him up, that he said that he was going to hurt him and make him bleed.
The fifth grader says things got so bad he was afraid to go to school and started thinking crazy thoughts.
Something about killing myself or running away or just hanging myself.
Jalen's story is not unique. Bullying is an issue that's making headlines all across the country, affecting kids from elementary school to high school. Bullying is defined as negative behaviors intended to frighten or cause harm, which may include written threats or physical harm. It is also described as teasing, harassing, or intimidation. In one high-profile case in Massachusetts, 9 students have been charged in the death of 15-year-old Phoebe Prince, who committed suicide after prosecutors say she was the victim of unrelenting bullying at her school.
The investigation revealed relentless activity directed toward Phoebe, designed to humiliate her and to make it impossible for her to remain at school. The bullying for her became intolerable.
Another case, 13-year-old John Carmichael of Texas hanged himself after being bullied by classmates because he was small. And this second grader tried to kill himself by jumping over a school balcony after other kids repeatedly pulled down his pants and embarrassed him.
Ajanae was bullying me for no reason, and he'd be wanting to fight me in the restroom.
Bullying has become so common that 41 states now have laws against it. Despite those laws, bullying is widespread and increasingly leads to deadly consequences. But not all bullying is so overt. Perpetrators of both sexes often work in groups where they use gossip, rumors, text messages, and harassing internet posts to bully.
It can be done because easily or more easily because it's autonomous. There's accessibility to the equipment, and it really, cyberbullying can be done 24/7.
Jalen's parents have complained to both the bully's parents and school officials.
I would like to see the school have a better handle of how, when there's a reportage of this student being a bully, there needs to be some level of discipline.
Dr. Linda Mental says the parents of bullies need to take responsibility for their child's behavior.
Parents need to stop making excuses for their kids' behavior. And I see a real crisis in the parents want the schools to do something about bullying. And then when the schools act, they get all upset. The parents get all upset and say, you infringed on my rights, and they threaten lawsuits.
Ron Luce of Teen Mania Ministries encourages Christian youth to take a stand against bullying.
Where are the Christians in those schools? You know, I'm sure there are Bible clubs. I'm sure there are youth groups in the area. It's time to rise up. And instead of just saying stop the bullying, if the kids themselves rise up and say, we're not going to tolerate this at our school or in our class or on our sports team or whatever, and the godly kids rise up.
Many schools have anti-bullying initiatives, including Jalen's, but that hasn't stopped the bullying in his case. We contacted the school, but administrators declined our request for an interview. Meanwhile, his family is frustrated, and his parents are helping him cope the best way they can.
My dad started teaching me how to fight, so every time they try to put their hands on me now, I grab their hand, and then
I told him, don't put your hand on me.
Charlene Israel, CBN News.
Stay with the CBN News Channel. We're coming right back.
Introducing Easy Combs, the easy new way to create dazzling new dos. Simply slide in one end, stretch it around your hair, and slide in on the other side for an updo that's brand new. Or fluff it out for a fountain effect. Look again. The bungee band stretch and release for a relaxed custom fit every time. Liven up a ponytail or create this amazing butterfly twist. It's great for short hair and ideal for the office. It's perfect for any formal occasion. Ouch, claw clips hurt. But Easy Combs are soft and comfortable, so easy to use, kids love them too. Now get Easy Combs in caramel bronze for only $10. Call now and get one in dazzling silver. As a special bonus, get our Bermuda black plus a styling DVD. Just pay separate shipping and handling. With the step-by-step DVD, Easy Combs are a cinch. You get caramel, silver, and black plus the style guide and DVD, a $60 value, all for only $10.
Call 1-800-520-1486. You'll get the bonus Easy Combs as advertised when you call 1-800-520-1486.
Love to shop for shoes, but there's no place to store them? You're always running out of room to store more. Introducing Shoes Under, the easy solution to organize and protect your shoes. The clear zipper cover locks out dust and moisture. Now you just slide and store. It's that easy. With two handles, you can easily store your shoes here, under there, almost everywhere, and turn an empty space into a super storage place. Other shoe organizers can cost a fortune, but through this exclusive television offer, you can get the 12-compartment Shoes Under for only $19.99. Call now and we'll cut that price in half. That's right, for only $10. And as a bonus, we'll double the offer and give you a second Shoes Under that's enough space for 48 shoes. Just pay separate shipping and handling. Call now and get two Shoes Under for only $10.
Call 1-800-943-1652. You'll get a second one free, so call 1-800-943-1652. That's 1-800-943-1652. Call now.
Finally today, it could be the most valuable coin ever found in Israel. Archaeologists there have excavated a gold coin that dates back nearly 2,200 years. It was found at Tel Kadesh near the Lebanese border. The coin only weighs 1 ounce, but it's worth an estimated $80,000.
This coin was equivalent to 100 silver coins in antiquity. It must have been equivalent to a half a year or a year's salary in one coin. Of course, people didn't walk around with such coins. This coin has ceremonial or symbolic significance and was probably meant to be used in a temple dedicated to Queen Arsinoe.
They believe the coin was minted in Alexandria. The image on the front could be a portrait of Cleopatra I. The ancient find is only the second gold coin from that time period that has ever been discovered. Well, that is going to do it for this hour of the CBN News Channel. You can find information on all the stories you've seen here at cbnnews.com. You can also stay up to date with CBN News through Facebook and Twitter. Hope you'll join us again right here next time. Have a great day and a wonderful weekend.
Fresh, wholesome juice. There's nothing like it. But until now, you had to stress and strain and make a huge mess to get just a little bit of juice. But not anymore, thanks to the Jack LaLanne Power Juicer. You can drop in whole vegetables, whole fruits, apples, oranges, celery, cucumbers with no chopping, no slicing, no struggling. And thanks to the Power Juicer's revolutionary patented extraction technology, you can get up to 30% more juice than those other juicers. Doctors recommend we get 5 to 9 servings of fruits and vegetables every day. With the Power Juicer, you'll be drinking your recommended daily allowance in just seconds. And the pulp from the extra large pulp catcher can be used to make pasta sauces, healthy desserts, and much more. The Power Juicer is dishwasher safe, so cleanup's a breeze, and the powerful motor is guaranteed for life. Order the Jack LaLanne Power Juicer now for just 2 easy payments of $49.90. And as part of this special TV offer, we'll also send you this amazing recipe guide filled with over 60 of Jack's favorite recipes. Try the Jack LaLanne Power Juicer in your home risk-free for 30 days. If you're not completely satisfied, send it back for a full refund of the purchase price, no questions asked. Call now.
I was always on the cusp of exploding. So I figured out if I get rid of the wife and the kids, then I can just send them money. Went to the junk drawer, I got the Bible out, put the tape in, and I believe that moment, Christ made sense. There is no earthly reason why we're still married. It is a divine intervention, and I thank God, in showing me what love, grace, and forgiveness looks like.